In this video, I'm going to show you all the new features that were just added in the Adobe Illustrator 2024 update and take you through how to use them. First up, we have the highly anticipated text to vector graphics. To open this, go up to Window and select Text to Vector Graphics. We can then select the Shape tool and draw out the area where we want our graphic to be. In this panel, we can select the type of graphic we want, and we can use this eyedropper to sample the graphic style that we want. So if I sample my illustration here, it will try to match its style. Then simply type in what you want to create, then hit Generate, and it's going to give you a few options to choose from. As you can see, this is a fully vector graphic which I can scale and move around. Now let's try to create a backdrop scene to my image. I'm going to draw my shape over the artboard and I'm going to send it to back. Then change type to be scene, and I'm going to type airport. Oh, and don't forget to sample your image. Once you've done that, hit generate. And we have a few results here. As you can see, they're not perfect, but it's a start and certainly helpful when you want to quickly test a concept. And it does a pretty good job of creating clean vector art. So next, we have the new Retype tool that can identify fonts from an image and lets you convert it into live text. To do this, have your image selected and go up to Type and down to Retype. This will then analyze and highlight text areas in your image. So select the area that you want to identify, and it will provide you with a list of fonts that will match it. You can filter these fonts by Adobe fonts and system fonts, and then once you've found a font that you like, you can download it straight from Adobe by selecting this cloud icon here. Once it's downloaded, double-click the text on your image to convert it to live text. Then if we hit exit, we can now type directly onto the image. And we can adjust it to where we want. This will be great for customizing images and prototyping designs. Next is the new Share for Review tool that makes collaborating and receiving feedback from clients easy. You can even share to those that don't have a Creative Cloud account. To do this, simply click the Share button in the right-hand corner, add your file name, adjust who has access, and click Create Link. Within the Share for Review panel, you have the flexibility to adjust access settings, even add a password by clicking More Options, Link Settings, hit this toggle here, and now you can set your password. To make sure they are seeing the latest designs, hit Update Content, then copy the link to share. Recipients with the link can access it with the password you created, then they can add any comments to the design. They can even add pins to comment on certain areas or mark out changes with this pen tool and attach comments to the marking. All comments appear live in your design file where you can reply and make any of the necessary changes. If you don't have the comments window showing, you can select it by going Window, Comments. Once a change has been made, you can resolve the comment by clicking this icon here, so you can track what changes you've made. Live comments can be toggled on and off by selecting this icon here, and you can also filter comments by reviewer, time, status, and any unread comments. Once you've finished making changes, go back to Share and click Update Content so those with the link can see the latest designs. This amazing new tool is going to save you time and streamline the review process. Next up, we have the new Contextual Task Bar that displays the most relevant actions in your workflow. So for example, if we select a grouped object, it's going to come up with options like recolor, ungroup, repeat object, duplicate object, and lock. Or when selecting text, we can change the font, font size, area type, and outline the text. Now this bar might get a little bit annoying as it follows you around, so we can simply move it out of the way, and it's going to lock to the new position. To reset this, select More Options and go Reset Bar Position. We can also hide the bar, which is going to remove it. To bring the contextual taskbar back, simply go up to Window and select Contextual Taskbar. Next, we have the new Mockup Tool, which allows you to mock up your designs onto any image. You can even explore the new Mockup Library, which allows you to mock up your designs in just one click. The first thing we need to do is find an image of our mockup. Paste your image into Illustrator and then add your artwork. And so I'm going to use my logo, and this needs to be a vector. Now we can position it roughly to where we want it on our image. Then select both the image and the artwork, and in the menu, go Object, Mockup, Make. You can now drag your logo around the file and position it to the best place. You can see it recognizes the shape of our mockup and distorts our artwork to match. We can play around with our blend modes under transparency to create a more realistic result. If you have an Adobe Stock account, you can also choose from a library of pre-designed mockup templates for various projects, from branding graphics to digital devices, saving us a ton of time when creating presentations for clients. To do this, make sure you have this mockup window active by selecting Window, Mockup in your top menu. Now, with your artwork selected, click the Mockup button here. This will apply the artwork to all the mockup templates. Select Edit on Canvas, and you can make changes by double-clicking your design and adjusting the frame. Last but not least is the Smooth tool. To do this, I'm going to draw a wonky line, and then with your line selected, go up to Object, Path, Smooth. This is going to open up this slider here where we can adjust the smoothness of our line. There's also this Auto Smooth button, but I prefer to do it manually as it seems to be more effective. And that's all the updates to Adobe Illustrator 2024. Let me know your thoughts in the comments below. And if you don't want to miss future updates, hit the subscribe button now, and I'll catch you in the next video.